Good evening, and welcome to the 10th anniversary of the Spriggs-Burroughs Dance Ensemble's production, annual production of the 10th anniversary of Art After Dark.
Thank you all. Yes! Thank y'all for coming out tonight. How y'all feeling? Y'all feeling worthy? Make some noise. I love it. My name is Isaiah Cunningham, and I'm the co-director for this year's show. I'm joined by my fabulous co-director,
Louis Kimbrough,
and this year's showrunner,
Miles Shannon.
Oh, period. For a little bit of background, Art After Dark began its tenure in the AUC in 2014 as a way for Spelman students and eventually students of all institutions to express their sexuality and creativity in a way that challenges the societal standards of the way that we view black bodies and sex.
Every year we have a theme that colors the context of how we execute this show, be it the four elements or the seven deadly sins.
But given that this year is a special year, we decided to do things a little different.
From the mind of Louis Kimbrough, we decided to approach this year's Art After Dark with a central narrative and a plot line that ties all of our pieces together.
As showrunner of this year's production, I took Louis' theme to the first ever Art After Dark writer's room to bring you an Afrofuturist time travel story the likes of which you have never seen before.
I know, that's exciting. But there are a few things that we have to cover first.
First, please do not record and please do not take pictures with flashing lights, as this can be a distraction to the cast and fellow audience members.
Food and drink in the Rich Theater is strictly prohibited.
This show does contain flashing lights, so photosensitive viewers should be mindful of that at this time.
Lastly, this show will have a brief 5-minute intermission.
Now, without any further delay, please enjoy the Spriggs-Burroughs Drama and Dance Ensemble production of
Art After Dark, Outta Time.
Ooh. another.
To be human is to love and use of hate.
A story set in all of time.
A boring tale much older than
it
you.
It begins now.
It began long ago.
Humans tried to love.
Humans breathe me.
You are telling this story. Things weren't perfect for people, but they were never this bad. It wasn't all at once, it was gradual, but somewhere, in a time not far from this one, humans forgot how to love. War and hatred, spite and malice, these forces tore our world apart and wiped everyone out. Everything was gone. Except them. All that is left of humanity lies in them. Convergent spirits of all who have ever been. And, if we're lucky, the promise of who we very well may be.
It is the dawn of our creation's 3,005th year. I wanted to say a wish for them.
Very well, my love. And I'll say one for them, too. I fear we've been asleep for far too long. They've forgotten us. We've become strangers to them.
Then they are gone. Lost without my touch.
You mustn't give up on that which does not have the utmost odds. Their potential is not lost. They may have forgotten us, but we have yet to misremember them.
They fancy themselves immortal, making themselves gods with technology, conquering the ultimate restraints of nature. Now look at them. Not gods and not even as they were before. They don't even know who or what they were before. They've forgotten themselves.
Then we will remind them.
Nearly forgotten it all. But memory isn't as fragile as I recall.
I can't believe it.
It actually worked. We're us.
We are definitely not us.
We're as close to ourselves as we can be. Is everyone all right? Was the transference successful?
Yes, I remember everything, but I feel like it's all missing.
Like you aren't quite whole yet.
Yes, or like...
You've been everywhere.
Or everyone.
Everything!
Yet you still don't really know anything at all.
I feel fine.
Hold up. Where are we?
Why are we?
Suffocating.
I mean, we are all that remains of the human race. Something was bound to be lost along the way.
So now what? We've lost ourselves the time we're supposed to do what?
Move on without it.
What if we're missing something that we can't live without?
If we couldn't live without it, we'd still be sleeping.
And if we're sleepwalking?
Then walk on.
If we're vital, we'd be limping at best.
My legs work fine, and there's breath in my lungs.
But do you know why you breathe?
I breathe to stay alive.
And if you were to find out that you weren't alive?
Or if a part of you had, I don't know, died?
Then how I felt wouldn't have mattered either way.
Sometimes feeling is the only thing that matters.
And where it doesn't, it gives off the sense to find what does.
Who said that?
What's going on?
Don't be afraid, children, for there is much to do.
A grave mistake has been made and can only be mended by you.
Who are you?
The voice of reason.
And a loving friend.
We are here to remind you of all that you have lost.
And guide your memories towards your future.
We thought we could preserve you like this, but the color has faded from your cheeks.
You must venture to reclaim it.
What is this?
The key to what you're missing.
Your reason for being.
Who are you to tell us what we don't have?
Let us jog your memories quickly as time is of the essence. What's important is you're all a little bit muted. You're the remnants of humanity holding immortality in your hands but devoid of something incredibly important.
What could be missing from someone who can live forever?
A reason to live at all.
There isn't much time left. Chosen vessels of the human race.
Scarlet, honey, sage, lilac, sapphire, and gray. You have an urgent mission.
How do you know our names?
We know the names of all of our children, and we know their hearts too. Which is why we know you have lost what makes you human. Scarlet, take that which is in your hand.
It is called the moment. Love and I kissed it and imbued it with the power of time. Use this to travel back to your past selves. Reclaim your history of love and sexuality before it is too late.
And if we don't?
Then you will never be whole again. And what is left of the human race will be destroyed, lost forevermore.
How will we know where to go?
There is no manual for time. You will simultaneously move faster and slower than you want or expect. Trust yourself and you'll know what you need to do.
But be careful. The moment is time itself. Should you destroy it, all that is will be over.
Will we see you again?
You should hope to never see us. Our beings exist outside of time. Should we ever come face to face, it could spell catastrophe.
On the back of the winds of time, the six vessels journeyed whenceward. To reclaim love lost to eras long forgotten, into their past lives they entered. Their mission was clear. To save what is threatened, they had to discover a truth. Love's light must persist no matter the darkness or evil in poisonous fruits.
Adam and Eve were sitting in a tree. F-I-G-H-T-I-N-G. First came love, and then a troubled marriage. Now it's resentment born of anger and despair. And no, it ain't from the fruit, and it ain't from temptation. The love just got stale, and they both ran out of patience. Humanity's first heartbreak. Two souls placed together by chance, not by choice, that were destined to love each other eternally and rejoice. Spawn love, make some love, then bring forth humanity with the love. Little problem, though. They both found something called their own thoughts and a voice. Thoughts and a voice that didn't align. But they'll make it work. They have to make it work. A notion they limitlessly lament upon themselves to ensure that the love lasts, out of the lurking fear of living in loneliness that they refuse to let consume them. Fear that the love will turn to loathing, that the sex steamed with passion will spoil into sadness for them to soak in, that the romance they romanticized in their savage minds will lead to tragic lies and the brutal truth that the existence they never asked for with the person they exist with truly brought nothing more than temporary bliss with a vast gap in listening sealed by a kiss. In one life, they were the first beings to make each other's hearts sway. In another, they were the first heartache, the first fight, the first souls to suffer, the first shade of gray in a world full of color, the first Will and Jada, the original sin to fester in generations later. So, one life, Adam and Eve were sitting in a tree, unaware of the broken hearts they will be.
Thank you.
civilization taught them a valuable lesson. For Scarlet, she unearthed the birth of her passion and need to be in one's possession. She uncovered a truth in the way that she moved, that the body is merely a cage, a capsule for the spirit to be touched by the flesh and express joy, pain, hope, and rage. Our hesitant vessels still needed more proof of the need for more feeling than this. A purpose for pleasure in spite of their pain, and if cuts could be healed by a kiss. So they ventured to timelines in the ancient past to see more sides to their story, but could never expect what they saw when they arrived. A godly and powerful orgy?
Let me bring it back down below the earth. Let me make it thorough. Rolo and me, you gonna see two or three because I'm always rocking with plurals. And yeah, I'll admit, this life ain't all glitz, glamour, diamonds, and thunder pearls. If you embark, it's a little snark and a little dark. Welcome to the underworld.
This will be like art in motion. Lift this hypnotic potion and you'll be swimming in an ocean of desire. The block is hot, but my body is hotter. I think we switched pantheons. I hear him calling me, oh, father. I can't wait for this part. It's you up in the succulent sound of playmaking. Cause in this club, I just wanna rum. So find me a month to take home and dump.
I promise you that everything will be so much better if you just follow my command. Being the god of war, I won't just bind you with measly rubber bands. I'll bring on chaos about the pussy. If you want me to be honest, and obviously my dick is undeniably the strongest. Aphrodite can vouch, but since the whole pantheon is here, I guess they can watch like a casting couch.
I don't know about y'all, but I'm here for the hips, tits, and clits. Goddess of the hunt, you'll never find me on a diff. My virtue is my promise, but still I can't resist when the ladies come a-calling. I can't help but assist.
King of the ocean, king of the waves, king of getting bitches wet 10 times a day. King of controlling the coochie like I control the waves. I'm pushing, pulling, and pounding that pussy by the way.
Let the whole world watch me pleasure you. Come closer, and let me measure you with my tongue. I'm feeling 9 inches deep and 2,000 years young. And for so long, I've so longed to liberate your mind with my licks and make you levitate with my kisses. Fill my mouth with your poison and poison me with your sickness.
I am the superiority that allows your whimpers and moans. I hold your pleasure in my hands, and when my mouth is found below your waist, your legs quiver and you whimper. I'm as good as it gets, there's no one similar.
Woo! Fuck up and fight back and fuck up some racks. Welcome to the party like, who got some wax? I'm professionally playing for this playful playtime, and my favorite human is Usher, so I want to hear a climax. God's sorry, I've been for a while, so whether or not you mind, let me give you some advice. I'm crafty, get at me, Poseidon, no, I get nasty. Hella pussy in these pockets, you would have thought I'm wearing khakis.
I am a husk of a god. I'll drink myself into oblivion. I taste the opium in the air to fill the moments with meaning. My tongue is dry. My liver is failing. My mind is gone. If I am the god of your fantasy, no, I bring treacherous libation. On the other shoe, I'm running through these niggas like Michael Myers. Who right next to me, I keep dick on high.
Okay, all right. Let me scope out and set the scene. I'm trying to see who I can rizz up and step between. Aphrodite looking mighty, but everybody wants that recipe. I see Athena shaking ass, and Artemis hating ass, and Lil Baby Persephone, pleasure me.
Man, Zeus got me going to this orgy. Boy, please. You already know all the goddesses got their hottest fits on for me. I mean, Persephone spread her legs for me, begs for me. She told me about my little bro, so don't worry. I'ma help water her flowers in this bed with me.
I presume I'll start with Hades. He could use a break from Persephone and a little sunshine. Or what's her name, Stephanie? I just call her head for me. Man, the head she gives is heaven to me.
Athena would've fucked me, begged for the cat on one knee.
Dionysus! maybe it's just sense. Maybe on this dick, since we're talking all that shit.
When I woke Aphrodite to this heavenly bed and give her this heavenly head, all of the glories of war seem to leave this homestead.
Where's Persephone? I'd like to make a pass. I mean, I know she has a husband, but I doubt that will ever last.
Fina, fina, mis adica, senorita. She my favorite screamer because she loved getting rough in these waters. You think your name was Aquafina?
Poseidon is fuck you like it's fuck your twin. Move on, I'm ducked off. Niggas think they came from.
Still, I better watch out for that nigga Apollo. He thinks he can have me, but this concept is hollow. I mean, yeah, he's cute, but you'll never catch me swallow.
I hear Artemis is coming.
She won't be doing much of that. She's a foolish goddess, thinking she don't need no phallus. Maybe that's why her heart is so callous.
I mean, Apollo, Artemis, and wifey want the dick.
Yeah, right.
All these hoes want to fuck, suck, and swallow all my kids. Hands around your hips, guys. My hands around your hips got you singing all the melodies. Hands up on the stick like you committing all the felonies. I got it too good, wonder if this shit is best for me. Reevaluation, this shit is feeling too heavenly.
Persephone doesn't fuck you like I do. Oh. Athena doesn't ride you like I do. When will you see I'm all you need? Everyone wants to fuck me. Everyone wants to experience me. So why are you talking to other goddesses besides me?
Can't you see this party is a total bore? Aphrodite will say she loves you, but she's just a clever whore. And Athena's a dominant demon that'll leave you unsatisfied and sore. So it's me,
my darling, that has you as my priority. And why have any of these men when you can just have more of me?
Ooh, got your nigga. Body problem with a book nigga. On one knee, baby, won't you come hither? Hey, at this point, call me a scholar, cause I'm getting straight A's. I'll be in decisive positions, cause y'all know I like to play. Got the foreplay in the Pacific, cause my body's so insane.
Ladies, lesbians, deities, divinities, make a splash and come into me. I got my shit open, come into me.
Man, I see hating ass folks everywhere I look around. Athena getting loud and Poseidon's gonna drown.
I'm glad you all can make it. Inside, I can't deny lighting up your world with one blink of an eye. How dare you, you sexy bitch, be so motherfucking relentless. Thank you all for coming. You'll be doing more of that soon. I presume you're prepared to assume the position most pleasing to me. Poseidon, lend me your water. Ares, lend me your flame. Let me take ye well rested and glistening or rusted and rotting. Allow me to put the heaven in your heavenly body.
Yeah! Another era, another thing to learn for. To uncover that love is the thing we all yearn for. And with sweet honey's lips now glazed with desire, both her and Scarlet had reignited their fire. Four more vessels still yet to be converted, and a journey still underway. Sage took hold of the moment to piece himself back together in the bondage of our shackled days.
We've had a lot of crushes. Some that we've long forgotten, some that we remember just a little too clearly and feel embarrassed about, some that we abandoned when there never seemed to be a chance between us. Now, we've worked on a lot of confusion and delusion about this queerness that we tried to push away. The nights that you begged me to vacate the refuge that I found in a pretty girl's kind eye. We've had a lot of fantasies, too. Dreams of warm embraces under stark moonlight, slow dances in silent bedrooms. And we've agreed on some terms. No cheaters! No self-proclaimed kings who find it much too easy to treat women like stepping stones. No manipulators who try to make a claim on everything that makes you confident. Uh-huh. No class clowns who can't even stay sober at the sight of your own tears. No thrill chasers who don't care to slow down, not even to soothe you as you tremble. Nobody who makes your family or your friends look at you with pity or worry. So, I hope that we can work together from now on. And I hope that you don't mind when I leap, when this boyfriend touches the small of your back, or how I ache when his heart and I momentarily misalign. But I hope that you've noticed my efforts in being good to this one, because I really do think that you found the kind of love that can help teach us what it means to tend to a flame.
Just like God, Nazareth, I'm fucked up, homie, you fucked up, but I got God. killers dead in the street for sure. Nigga, I'm in a preacher's door. My knees getting weak and my gun might blow, but we gon' be alright.
Sapphire needed their supplier. He thought that times too far in the past wouldn't show him the way. So instead, we enter recent history to find love in familiar days.
I want you to pour your pain on me, oh yeah. And I'm not sure if you try to like what's happening when you ride my way. Oh, my baby. Oh, my baby.
down into this fine little shawty, and we was chopping it up for a bit. Oh, got the digits and everything.
Oh, shit. Okay. My fault, Pam.
Appreciate that, dog. She a bad little thing. Great personality, great figure, great everything. I think Shorty might be the one.
Nigga, shut the fuck up. You always fall in love with the first girl that gives you attention. Talk about baddest little thing. Shorty might be the one.
Uh-oh, this could be the one ass nigga. This is the one ass nigga.
Yes, bro. How many times you gonna find the one, but they ain't never the one? Like, bro, when are you gonna be the one? Hey, what is that?
Not too much.
Okay. So what makes her so special?
Man, Shorty's different. She makes the brightest stars seem dim. When I saw her, all a nigga could do was hold his brim. That twinkle in her eye or her dimples when she smiled. Heart rate so fast, felt like I was running for miles. Ass fat, natural, shape of the skin, titties out. You know what I'm saying?
Did this nigga just rhyme? No matter where you go, you sip it every time. I mean, I want to know how many girls you fall in love with every day. From what I remember, there's a Jasmine, Chanel, two Brandies, and like three Chanaes.
Damn.
If you ask me, that love shit ain't real. All I need is a blunt, some Netflix. To me, that sound like a deal.
Yeah, man, I see where you're coming from. That love shit, it's hella confusing. Within the shit, you never know if you're winning or losing. Like, you could go from locking eyes to kissing and smooching to compromising, picking and choosing.
Like, exactly. Like, that love shit has never done shit for me. Y'all be out here cheating, fucking, brokenhearted, gleefully. See, I'm cooled off love. It's never warm my spirit. Only cause pain and heartache, and sometimes I drown it out in spirits.
And then you gotta wrap your head around the fact that maybe this love shit just don't work out, you know?
Exactly. Like, I don't even fuck with nobody anymore, because either you broke or you a whore.
Y'all are tweaking! Making love seem like a bad thing. I'll take time from front to back, from first line to bookend, and over again. To be more concise, all I think about is love.
Exactly. This, I mean, it's like water. It's all around us, yet treated like a commodity, so I don't get how y'all don't get why I'm acting this way about Shawty. I mean, just think about it. She fulfills all of my apparent needs, nigga. I met her quirky on my knees.
Get the
fuck. I'm blind to everyone else because she's all that I see. All I want is her vibe, her company, and a rub on her juicy booty. Is that too much to ask for?
See, y'all be talking about the right one will come, but that shit hasn't happened yet. They say love will overcome, but that shit hasn't happened yet. With love, men will become, but that shit hasn't happened yet. And it never will, and that's a bet.
Hey, bro. Now, love can make you feel a little fickle and make you feel like you want a pickle, but love can also be beautiful and make you feel delusional. Now, for example, last shawty I was with, we were tussling shit. I showed up love all the time, but she wasn't convinced. Now, with that being said, this love shit, it ain't all about the ups and downs and twists and turns, more so about the experience and the shit you learn.
Yeah, like if it's just a feeling or really has a deeper meaning, I just want to learn every thought that passes by or what that movie made you cry. The violence to the think pieces I could write about my love if only I was allowed to poke and prod, tease and knot the creases of your pink matter. Press and probe your frontal lobe. Call me McConaughey, I'll take time. If love is interstellar, damn, maybe I should tell her.
See? Now y'all getting it. I know I talk about love all the time, and I know it can be a bore, but it's all been on my mind from the start. There are days where I do nothing but pick the fabrics of love apart. A nigga like me, I describe it as art. A nigga like me, I sculpt with my heart, and niggas try to clown me for it. Nigga, you ain't ever been in love. How you finna say it's unimportant? This love shit is beautiful.
Man, I guess I'll see or feel that love shit when I actually see it.
It's
all right.
It's
going
to I'm through.
Nearly at the place where time stood still, our vessels were running out of history. Lilac and Gray, still lost in the dark, still needed to solve the mystery of why the heart must beat in succession to a worthy encounter with fate. They need to see that to be who they are, they had to overcome hate. The power of love is a hell of a drug. It's easy to get lost in its mist. And soon our vessels would come to discover it's mighty hard to resist. But in the modern time of 2023, we need love now more than ever. Welcome to the modern era, our last chance for pleasure.
So your brain wouldn't scramble like eggs, okay?
Even though that sounds convincing and very real, please just get out of my room.
Girl, if you don't shut your dumb ass up and just let me talk, I'm not gonna tell you again.
Now that does sound like something I would say.
I'm you. Just let me prove it. You have a scar on your left arm from when you decided it would be a good idea to play tag with a German Shepherd when you were like seven.
I don't know. You could just be one of those very hardcore stalkers.
Now, how the fuck does that make any sense?
I'm just saying, I've told people that story before. It's not like it's some secret I never told anybody. Mm.
So you want a secret? Okay. You always thought that if you could fuck your clone, you wouldn't need to fuck anybody else ever again.
Oh my god. You are me.
What? No, no.
Then why are you here?
I'm here to stop you from making the worst decision of your entire life.
Decision? What decision? Oh, girl, hold on. I gotta respond to this dude. I wanna hang with him, but I did kinda tell my homegirl he's blocked.
I'm here to stop you from making the decision of letting this dude back into your life. That boy ain't shit and you know it. By continuing down this path, you're putting yourself and the fate of the entire world in danger.
Yeah, but really, what should I say?
Don't text Mr. Neanderthal. The fate and stability of our world depend on it.
Hey, don't call him that.
Girl, be fucking for real. He looks like a caveman. This nigga's face is prehistoric. I know you just want to see him so you can feel good for a little while. I get it. I wouldn't be here right now need some sense left into you.
Can you please just get off my dick and go back to whatever timeline or universe you came from and mind your business? I know he's not the one or whatever, but if I had to spend another night by myself, I might just lose my mind. That's all I want is to fill this empty void inside of me.
No. I know you feel that instinct in your chest telling you that this dude is no good. I literally traveled through time to tell you this shit, okay? Look, I've only been to one other timeline, the one where you block him, and bitch, that's the one you want to be at. The world hasn't been thrown into complete chaos, and we're thriving there.
How could this one thing possibly cause all of that?
It's a long story. I don't got time for all that right now. What matters is you're always so unsure of everything. And here's a sign from the universe, literally tackling you to the ground, staring you in the face, and telling you that you need to listen to yourself. Listen to me. Every minute you spend alone is time you learn to love yourself instead of chasing love from somebody else.
Hey, fine. Do it, just get off of me, please.
Okay.
There, it's done. See?
Thank you.
Well, I'm not doing anything again tonight. What are you doing?
No. This isn't happening. Delete Instagram, call mom, and go meditate. I did my job. I'm leaving.
All right. Well, good night, Dr. Strange.
Shut the fuck up. Hey, Jasmine.
Yeah.
I'm proud of you.
Yeah. I'm proud of us, too. Thanks.
Yes.
Anytime.
Yeah.
aggressive and you throwing blows again. Said your sensitivity ain't the problem, but you know it is. You make me wanna fuck with a condom or never stroke again.
Yeah,
that's where I'm at with it now. Remember when you told me you ain't wanna burn bridges down? Now every conversation got us verbally getting loud. The fuck
you,
fuck that, the issues and cum rags and all the shit you saying that I put you through. What's
you
that?
You get hella detached, so I get hella attached. And then you call me on my shit and I feel hella attached. Flashbacks, back shots, now I get headaches and shit. Now I can't even relax, now I need medics and shit. Yeah, nigga, I said my anxiety got worse with you. And I'm sick of all the fucked up shit that you do. So fuck your trash ass opinion.
Man, fuck you and your feelings and fuck your crazy ass friends.
And they was right in the end.
Man, fuck your lying ass ex.
Well, he was better at sex.
Man, fuck your mom and your dad.
At least mine got a bag.
So what? Is that supposed to hurt? Make me fucking go berserk? Talking about why you all up in my shirt? Got my hoodie, got my sweats, got my wallet in your purse. Better start acting grateful before you end up on the curb. You make shit complicated, you always acting basic. I know you feel the burden if a nigga stop chasing. You always fucking raging, you always trying to say shit. I know, I'm about to leave your ass so you can finally learn patience.
Oh, I ain't got no patience? You sound fucking silly. And if I'm acting crazy, then you're acting willy-nilly. You're a bully, a bozo, a bum, and a bitch. Don't be all up in my face tomorrow asking for a kiss.
Wow, you really think that low of me, huh? Like, how do you expect my ass to show you the love? Out here whining and crying like, I got hella attached cause you got hella detached.
Yeah.
I should've listened to my friends when they said you was trash. See how my message is relevant? I'm out here trying to smash, but you trying to be celibate. I'm a pain in the ass, but that's kinda irrelevant. I'm trying to show you love and you seem to evidence.
I'm trying to put me first. You're the worst thing, you know it. You keep saying that you love me, but you never want to show it. Throwing jabs at my character, feelings overflowing like that liquor on your breath, except I'm not the one to pull it. Instead, I pour myself, I put my health on a back burner, but ended up getting burned. This ain't like a Tina Turner, I'm turning a new leaf. Star Garden's buried, so hit me up when you in therapy and don't fuck at Carrie.
So that's it?
I'm fucking done.
Done?
Oh, nigga, that's it. I keep saying this shit. Done with you.
No, girl, you doing a lot. Girl, don't do
it. I'm doing a lot.
Girl, hey.
Nigga, what?
You hungry?
Yeah, you know I'm hungry.
Come on, I know you're not you when you're hungry.
Whatever.
Right now, you gon' move on with your life. Fuck you, nigga. You love a bitty party. I won't show up. Always gon' fuck who?
You heard me, nigga. Right. It's nothing.
You know what?
Fuck you, nigga.
Bitch. Fuck you, bitch.
No, fuck you, nigga.
Fuck you, bitch.
No, fuck you, nigga.
Fuck you,
fuck
bitch.
You.
Fuck you,
nigga.
Bitch.
Fuck you. Fuck you.
Fuck you.
Fuck you.
Fuck you. Fuck you. Fuck you, bitch. Fuck you, bitch. Stupid. I don't even know why I fuck with you.
I'll be damned if I stuck with you.
Change my number, I'm ducking you, bitch.
Bitch, whatever is comfortable.
This the type of shit couples do. Should've thought about cuffing you.
Nigga, you dirty and you broke.
Oh, you goofy and cunnable.
The fuck is you talking about?
Never mind, bitch, I'm walking out.
Whatever, nigga, I'm off you.
Your
now.
Evil ass kept me well in doubt.
Pussy, nigga, best watch your mouth.
Pussy in mouth is all you got.
Lay this pussy back on the couch.
Doggy style, then you get on top.
Fuck me, nigga.
I'ma fuck you, bitch.
Nah, fuck me, nigga, fuck me.
I'ma fuck you, bitch.
Nah, fuck you, fuck me.
You're playing, man.
Fuck me.
My more house brother for fuck's sake!
make sure to keep giving him reasons to.
Yo, I gotta cut out.
Can I know where you're going?
Yeah, I'm Keisha. She's she won't hit me a retwist.
What?
I want to see it all. Gray.
Scarlet? Honey?
Gray.
Lilac?
Gray!
Who's that?
Think of me as an old friend.
I think I've had more than enough of old friends.
Even your old pal, love?
Never much cared for her.
You say that maybe you despise her.
Maybe. I just don't see the point in love.
You hate her. You hate her.
You hate her!
Someone can love selflessly their entire life and still die the most agonizing of deaths. The only truth is, you live until you die. And even we found a way to cheat that. Love is a distraction with no grounding in reality. That's why humans lost their way. So long ago, they foolishly fell for the lie of love. See, if they were like me, if they understood the world how I do, they would never have made the mistake. They would never have sought destruction in the name of love.
Gray, what if I told you could destroy love forever?
How?
It's really quite simple. I mean, all you have to do is destroy the moment in which she resides.
The remote.
Take back your moment, Gray. Destroy it and bring its remains to my domain at the end of time.
How will I get there?
When the deed is done. I will call out to you. Just follow my voice.
How do I steal a moment?
You wake up.
That was healing.
Beautiful.
Powerful.
And fucking incredible. I mean, could you believe how many lifetimes we had way back when? Dude, how many times I've hated someone and loved them again?
Oh my God.
I didn't know that I could care for so many people in that many lifetimes. I mean, it's kind of wild, right? The fact that we carried the same loving instincts, no matter where or when or who we were.
We really left so much behind. I had forgotten what it all meant.
Mm-hmm. I mean, to caress every crevice of someone's skin until I've memorized the valleys of their body.
To explore every accessible part of their mind until I can tell what they're thinking just by the twitch of their mouth.
To live in a lie.
What are you talking about?
To love is to live in a lie. You're so blind. All the lies we've lived, you still ignore all the dark. You ignore all the light. This is all wrong.
It can't be wrong needing something. To cling to someone in this divine feeling, to find a home in someone.
Do you not hear yourself? You're basically calling yourselves incapable of standing in your own. As the last standing members of humanity, are we not supposed to be strong? You're too wrapped up in how you feel to see any objective truth. I mean,
Think about it. Isn't that selfish? To only have your emotions based off of someone else. That you have to live in their mind, traverse their thoughts to your heart's content, to seize their soul and use it to your own end. And then what? Don't you wonder that when your love has learned all that they can, that they're gonna leave you? Or will you justify all this time being wasted on one person by calling it love? I'm just trying to show you that love is distracting you. I mean, ask yourselves, why were we even created? There's something more. Love and reason are not telling us. Why can't you see that?
Just because you don't get love doesn't mean you have to shit on everyone else.
Why do I bother? You all act like you understand me, but I think you just need a reason to judge me.
Nobody expects anything from you. You can learn about love again.
I don't want to! Don't you get that? I don't need some half-assed solution. I'm not broken!
No! You are not!
They're nothing but children, and you, they're distorted peons.
Hate's influence was strong. He cast his darkness out across the scattered fragments of time as he sought to guide Gray towards his wicked domain.
Oh, this feels good. I am the shadow looming over every conversation. My darkness knows no bounds. I fuel fires and drive relationships to their destruction. I am the inescapable influence waiting patiently in the depths of your heart. Catch me if you can.
part of me.
When I first awoke, I gazed into the great blankness of the universe, eager to feel all I could.
My curiosity and desire overrode my caution. I approached you.
You introduced yourself.
Love? And you are?
Reason.
You welcomed me into your arms. I saw the expanse of the world in your eyes.
You taught me how to love.
You and I were whole before we were weak, but we became something more by coming together.
This place that we created is a testament to our beauty.
And now it is destroyed.
You said we were never supposed to see you, but we can see you!
You thought we'd see you within us!
We did everything we were supposed to do!
None of us have any clue what we're supposed to do!
Silence!
Your fondness for my gift of love has led you to shun one of your own.
Now Gray has been lured away by hateful forces beyond our reach.
Lured away by what?
Or who? What aren't you telling us? We are not the only forces in this universe that are watchful slaves to time.
We thought that we had banished them long ago, but just as our gentle whispers can aid you in your hour of need, so too can the vengeful voice of another woman drop silvery tongue in the ear of dear Gray.
My greatest adversary, the god of hate.
He seeks to destroy what beauty love and I have created. He was shackled to the fragility of time itself, but with the moment destroyed, Gray is now within his reach.
How is Gray gonna find him?
Hate's domain lies at the far edge of time, at the distant future.
Well, how do we get there?
With the moment destroyed, the way forward is uncertain, unclear.
The future is a fickle thing, and without our influence, no love or reason could protect the fabric of these realities.
If you want to save your friend and all of existence, you must go into the future that we cannot follow. Find the shattered fragments of the moment and imbue it with the kiss of six.
Wait, so now we have to find the god of six?
Girl, no!
The six is the six of us.
Including Gray.
Why can't you guys do it?
I beg your pardon?
If you're these powerful primordial beings, what's stopping you from destroying hate? The futures that you must go to, we cannot follow. Our presence doesn't allow us to go to these distant timelines.
We are bound to this moment until the timeline is restored.
So, let me get this straight. Lovebirds. All we have to do is race through futures and times without love to find Gray and convince him that he shouldn't destroy love and all the existence, even though that's basically what he's always wanted to do? Sounds easy enough.
It may not be easy.
But it is necessary.
How will we know where to go? Do you love Gray?
Without a doubt.
Then follow your heart. You will find them, no matter when they are.
Sometimes love is less than ideal. In this future, you'll see it's anything but real. But in order to find Gray, this is where they must go. But if they'll survive it, who really knows?
Today, I woke up with you beside me. Is this love? I arose and showered before you woke, spoke quietly on the phone before you left for work in order not to disturb you. Is this love?
How good it is to see you, my love. Early before the day begins, pour your thoughts into my hands. They are my responsibility to bear. This is love.
You bear me and I heed, then you leave undeniably. I feel freed in your absence. Is this love? It feels unfaithful.
Keep my mind grateful. When beautiful women approach me, I don't let my mind wander because you are my trophy. This is love.
A traditional trophy wife who stays home and bides time, who smiles until you arrive and greet me with the same line upon entry. Is that love?
I endure the aches for that job every day, just to come home to you every day, but I'd gladly lie in the streets if I am with you. You are my love.
As a child, I wished for my proper Prince Charming, but with no dragons to conquer, it seems we've squandered the concept of heroism.
I may not be Prince Charming, but I am yours.
I may not be him, but I am yours. And that is all I'll need to be. This is not just love. You are my love.
And I know questioning brings shame to us. That I should trust our compatibility and ability to support each other. That to your children I am a mother, and to you I am a lover as you hover before me. Deep in the sheets you release comfortably inside of me. Is that love? We fuck and we fornicate, no need to anticipate, as never do we stray from what's worked before, as if fucking is just another chore to cross off our weekly to-do list. Is that love?
We need not fuck nor fornicate, but I will pursue and appreciate what I've not been seeing for how long you have been bleeding.
This mundane strain of standing beside you, this plain pain of existing here, as the definition of love has been left unclear.
The love I have died a million times for. The love I have cried and dried my eyes for. The love I will scream on the rooftops for. The love I will sit and file my taxes for. All for you, my love.
I wake next to you and your children I bear. I share every ounce of my existence with you for your world.
To gain our love has faltered. Bring unthinkable pain to my altar.
But still, I wonder if I will ever be able to curl into what they once called intimacy. So intricately and sophisticatedly defined, I live this life, yet none of it feels like it's mine.
I know this is just my love. But by hook or crook, by whoever sold the book, my love will be ours.
I live for you. I live for others, but never once have I been smothered with the thought my soul was tethered to you.
I want to be cut up for the task because I want to be your love.
And now when I make your food and set the mood, it all feels routine.
And I will cry, and I will do what I have to do to find your love. My love, you are my love.
And this confession will not change my personal direction. For what we have is functional. Fictionally fantastic fairy tale forever after.
And I will not let us fade away. Because this love, my love, will last another day.
In theory. And yet I'm weary because I woke up this morning by your side. And my mind's decided. I don't love you.
Dear you, sometimes I get scared that I'll love you and receive no love in return. And I know that I shouldn't love with any expectation of a transaction, but sometimes I do, because I'm human, and I'm weak.
Hey, I know we haven't been talking for that long, but I wanted to know what I am to you.
Here we fucking go. I touch you softer than anyone before, I kiss you, whisper the sweetest nothings in your ear, and yet you still gotta beg for the one thing I can't give you.
Most of the times, I think I feel your love without you saying it, but in those sometimes I get scared that it's all imagined. I've known love, and yet right now it's like I've never known anything.
Am I a single flower in a lonely field? Am I delicate to you? Am I like popping a piece of bubble wrap the second before it makes that perfect sound? Do I satisfy you? Or am I like chewing mint gum and drinking ice cold water? Do I send chills down your spine? Who am I kidding? I can never be these things for you. But I want to be.
I crave reassurance and for your mouth to whisper in my ear that you want me, need me, love me.
You want, you want, you want. And I give, but you don't see that. I give you orgasms, food, my time. I give you more of me than I've given anyone. But because it's not everything, it's not enough.
Lick from the puddle I give you and stop asking for an ocean. It was never that deep.
But I also know that it's healthy. And I don't want a love with you that's so bright it burns away the rest of you. I've known that too. I want you. Love you. And most days, I don't need you. I stand on my own and am glad for my independence, the ability to love you and still love myself and others. But sometimes, I want what's unhealthy, to indulge in a bit of toxicity, because sometimes my brain and heart get their wires crossed and need your love to be like a weighted blanket.
I want to be that random cool breeze of wind on a hot day. I want to give you relief. The pit in your stomach before you try something new. I want to make you flustered. I want to be one of those soft, cushy pillows. I want to be your comfort. I want to be all of these things to you and so much more, but forget about me for a second. I want to tell you what you are to me.
I want you to be the soft pair of thighs I rest my head on after a long day of work. I want you to be the pot of honey that gets sticky sweet on my fingers. I want you to accept what I have to offer. Nothing more, nothing less. I want you to close that pretty mouth unless your lips are on mine. Forget about love.
And as I write and think and cry, I know and don't know whether I'll ever let these words reach you.
My love, you are like watching a movie and realizing it sucked ass.
You're a waste of time. You're like going to the store on a specific craving and the entire shelf is empty.
Yeah.
You're disappointing. Yeah. You're a pop-up window that won't close, an infant with an ear infection, a dog begging for food on a full stomach, a kid who learns a new word and will not shut the fuck up. You are all of these things to me and so much more. You remember everything except me, and it fucking hurts.
Yeah, Nina.
Does it matter how I feel if it's only sometimes? Does it matter how I feel if it's only because of a heart broken by men who were transients in my life long before I knew you? I know it's not you, or at least I think it's not you that's the root of the issue. You care for me and hold me and love me silently. And maybe that's because of a brain and heart broken before I could love you. My soft touch and love letters.
You don't even fucking know me!
Oh, wow.
You saw in me the stud of your dreams, but really, I'm just the stud of your wet dreams. You think I've disappointed you, but I've just been myself, not the vision you had in your head. You're not my fucking mama. I don't gotta prove shit to you. Just because you've made yourself feel so small doesn't mean I'm big and bad. I'm just a real ass bitch. You're just as fucked up, shit, maybe more. I ain't got shit to say sorry for, so don't hold your breath.
I want you, love you, and most days I don't need you.
We are a deformed match made in heaven. Our souls flirt with the devil whenever we try to cleanse the red out of the flesh.
Sometimes I get scared that I'll love you, and receive no love in return.
You came into my life, my orbit. So rotate around my center. You can't be my light, so settle for my shadow. If you want more light, you can have the strobe in the club. We can be anonymous and rock our bodies together and practice around what will come later.
Enough of the analogies and metaphors. I like you, and you probably don't like me back. If you did, I would see you during the day. I only hear your voice at night. What are we to each other, besides temporary?
Dear you, sometimes I get scared that I'll love you, and receive no love in return. And I know that I shouldn't love with any expectation of a transaction, but sometimes I do because I'm human.
Thank you.
timing was wrong, then we can try again. If you think you're moving on, baby, let's try.
Imaginable, would we still be humane? When our hearts are metallic and made of machine, there's no way love's vision could ever be seen. See, if love is eternal, like in this future here, you'd find only darkness and an eye filled with tears.
Definitely know how to lead someone in. Organized, not doing the most. Simple but outstanding, could never boast. Too bad for you, you're too good to be true. This feels real scary. Hold on. Let me call Stephanie.
Looking for love. Hugs and cuddles come funny with wit, and I'll have rebuttals. I'm the perfect girl to take home to your mother. I cook and I clean and I never cause trouble. Bubble baths and romantic laughs and doing cute shit like daytime naps and sitting on laps and matching hats. So please hit my line if you're looking for that.
I'm not the type of nigga to tell your friends about. See, I'm a soul sanctified, feet chic, a metaphysical man whore, if you please. A man you've been manifesting in your dreams. Why hide my intent? I wanna place your pleasure on top. Go for 1, 2, 3. I hit every spot and don't stop. Okay. I'm multifaceted. Have you leaked more than you're faceted? And I made that act right too. I'm not the type of nigga to tell your friends about. Be honest, baby. You couldn't even get the words out.
I swipe right on this nigga once. Tall, dark, and handsome with hands that look like they put work in. Look like they could buy me a Birkin, working graveyard shift so the dick was nocturnal. And I played my part so he thought our love was eternal. But as long as he whining and dining, then I'm whining and rotting. Just keep them dollars coming and you can come inside. Never mind, nigga. Just zip for the night.
Shawty, dad. Go ahead, bitch. And nothing better than a pretty big, go ahead, bitch. Yeah. And she looked just like my type. Might just have to give her ass a call. I'm out here swiping right. I'm trying to get into them draws. I'm here for a good time, not a long time. Fuck relationships. I'm never all yours. You're never all mine. Need a bad bitch that I can call fine. Hopefully she's not a feminist. And I'm hoping that we get intimate. Don't want a bitch who don't got sense, because then I'm fucking up her innocence. But for real, though, I like long walks on the beach and massages on my feet and books I can read and living this dream. LOL. I'm just playing. I like to fuck. Fuck till the sunrise. Really only here for some hookups and one night. So swipe right if you want to have a fun time. All up in my bed, got it sounding like drumline.
Swipe left with my chest. I'll never see you in my bed. I know you ain't for my best, so I'll leave you to rest. Maybe fun for a night, but I'll be left alone too soon. So I ain't getting caught up over some ain't shit ass dude.
I'm ugly. So it's okay if you don't swipe right. I can be emotional support if you're not looking for piping. Even if I'm not your type, I'll still be around. Lingering and nagging, being a thorn in your side. Girls never text me back on this app, and I just don't know why. I mean, ugh, look at me. I'm such a nice guy. I'm always giving these hoes, queens, compliments, and never getting my dick sucked. I mean, I have the worst luck, but maybe you'll be different. I hope I didn't offend you. There's no need to get belligerent.
Mm-mm. I swipe left on this nigga, left that nigga on red. He kept talking about his feelings and he couldn't give him. I said, rich nigga, eight figure, that's my type. Broke nigga swipe left, never swipe right.
To the left, like Beyonce said, what the fuck you think this is? Let me tell you, a dead end. I'm not picky or petty, and you could probably push a pin at me, but you look like you suck on a straw after you done with the Capri.
I swipe right when I think you'll spend my time right. Take me out somewhere nice, get me a bite. Maybe then we can start ourselves a life. Married, three kids, happy, never fight. That's the future I invite, so let's get a match since you're matching my type.
Wow. You really chose me. I hope you don't leave me. If I told you I love you, I hope you believe me. I'll do anything for you. I'm at beck and call for you. It's you and me forever.
I'm trying to fuck on a six-figure fuck nigga with fantastic fingers and hella visas. I'm a screamer for dick and dollars, career man, corporate cuties, and big ballers. I'm talking pleasure for pesos, kitty for coins, be the light of my life and the fire of my loins. Lengthy checks make me wet, not long walks on the beach. To see you count that currency is what's gonna make this pussy scream in the C's and them G's. Feeling that nigga get hard, I start to whisper his ear, baby, pull out that card.
Thank you.
were, if we knew not our own hearts, if we forgot what is his and what is hers, would we ever be able to restart? If we were lost like our vessels today, would we be able to still find our way? Back to humanity and out of the shadows? Or would we be monsters, asleep in the gallows?
Let me perform for you. Allow your eyes to follow my form and watch me feed you. I want you to come for me.
Storm in the middle of the night with my baby. Open my legs. Drive me crazy.
Sit down and let your body feel me. Feel me within your orgasm.
Scuba dive, take pride in your own personal shrine.
And feel me within your fantasy.
I'm 25 and overdrive.
I know you scream for me.
You need this.
Scream for me.
You need me.
Get lost in me.
Deep, deep, deep down.
But find your way back to me.
Round by round by round.
Dream of me.
Go down into your sea.
And you will see
Lake Superior, baby.
How my hands hold your thoughts.
Slick lick spits,
and my tongue carries your emotions.
Blessing me with all of it.
Allow my hands to find a home.
My desires and dreams.
And my bare skin to be a fabric for your insecurities.
Hearing you moan and scream.
Can't you see how my body belongs to your being?
Your body's shaking.
And my soul gets lost in your eyes as you moan.
And toes pointing stroke after stroke.
This is my performance. This is my show.
About to explode. You are my finisher.
And I wish for you to watch. Watch me submit to you.
Look into each other's eyes.
And be in you.
Bind brother to impulse.
I will praise a temple.
Pulse by pulse, craving you and your soul for eternity.
But find myself intertwined between your walls.
Let me perform for you.
But promise to give me a standing ovation when the night ends and the show is over. I want you to lay there. Smell my scent within your shoes.
If love still mattered in this future here, it would mean everything, that much is clear. But the kind of love you'll here see is an illusion. As our vessels enter, mind their intrusion. We're almost out of time to show them the way. This is our last chance to speak out to dear Gray. Can this last timeline shine on our vessels, or will hatred win the day?
Welcome to Kingstar Galactica, our enterprise dedicated to the study of human sexuality. Eons ago, before we alien life forms annihilated the human race, they had a myriad of kinks and fetishes, even something called BDSM. Although humans have met their extinction, we have preserved a select few to study their sexuality. Here they are now.
Choke is not enough. Whisper directions in my ear as you rub it on the boss. When we F it, I'm a G as I'm coming for your spot. I'm going in, drilling so hard, got you calling on the holiest. Fingers in your mouth, going further in your throat again. Dripping wet, but we ain't use the oil or petroleum. Sliming when we finish as we feel like Nickelodeon. I love seeing someone covered in my hickeys and bruises, it makes me feel like a proud dude. Ding, 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 I'm ready for round two.
Oh, no.
And go and let it out, I'm fucking it loud too. And you can call me daddy as long as it sounds cool.
Oh. Hi, I'm a voyeur.
Hi, I'm a voyeur.
I'll watch. Carefully and curiously, I'll watch. I love the shape of your form, mourning your loyalty, wishing to be scorned. Let me watch you be taken over by another. The deep breaths as you recover from their touch, you trust me enough to witness such an event. The shift in your hips, your back, arch and bend, extend your legs and bring them in closer. The motion of the two of you, me watching you choke her. You look to me as you gasp for air. The tension between us during such a scandalized affair.
Hi, I'm Bondage.
Hi, Bondage.
I got a locked in. My grip strong as steel, tantalizingly tight to her appeal, hands tied to her liking, I got her locked in. Locked to the bed, arms and legs spread, nothing's been said cause she lets her moans do the talking, she a freak like Meg, I got her locked in. Oh. I'm intimate, persistently considerate of where she be wishing I kiss, I lick or I dip on the clit, shawty satisfied efficiently, handcuffs, leash shit, she likes my intricacy. We both be seeing the vision, but she be begging for the blindfold because she prefers to be listening.
so this is how I make it better when she mad, when she gagged up, literally. When she open it up like a flower, jump cut. We going hours for hours, ox up, blasting hours and hours. But we not done because we be in the shower for hours. Her face down, ass up, she got pussy power for hours. But the sex drive stacked up because when we at the pussy pound, we go round for round for hours. Yeah. I be stretching that out for hours, dicking her down when she bound for hours. We be getting wild for hours. I got a lot to. Some freaky shit we do. But if she rocking with it, then I mean, shit, man, lock me up too.
What?
Chip in a Pringle can.
Shooting stars.
Stars dream of flying far.
And rich men dream of flying cars.
I dream about this love like Pluto dreams of being a planet.
I dream so much the Sandman ran out of dust.
You owe rent to my pink matter.
Matter of fact, I believe in our love. Like suns believe in shining, or stars believe in perfect timing.
Or we believe in astrology.
Like Christians believe in Genesis.
And Jesus believed Judas.
I believe in the stories sung by your stardust. How if the universe went cold, you would be its big bang.
Baby, I believe in our love.
More than a black hole believes it can destroy, or space knows it can take. Like a black hole is a space that takes, upon entrance you
take me and tear me apart. Strip me down to my atoms the closer I get to you.
I watch your time and passion escape myself as we fall deeper like dippers.
And Dipper and Mabel find a town a little fishier.
And our constellations combine a little quicker.
You compose lullabies with a blast from your meteor. Your voice compels sound waves when compelled to collect up the wind and tease it and erase it on the in and out of my ears.
You look the best when illuminated by sunlight and complemented by the smiles in your eyes at the height of moonlight.
On your outside you shine with the beauty of quadrillion suns, but your inside is dark and turbulent.
An abyssal vacuum.
Something unattainable.
Inescapable.
Incomprehensible.
It's insensible. You make my heart beat.
Out of my chest.
My soul sing.
Louder than rest, singing songs of our wrapped arms and your charm. And ooh, you're so smart.
And so I orbit you. Because thinking about you is thinking about. Eyes on the moon and a moving car. Wonder if she's following me too.
The most prettiest and precious thing may be the sound of the way you breathe.
I count the lashes on your lids as you lay asleep.
Seeing is believing. I repeat that I see the stars and I see you and me.
I believe in love brighter than any sun commits to a shine. And you believe in the importance of vitamin D.
Baby, I think about your body like bodies of water body each other when crashing. And I don't want to bother you with comments about our bodies bodying, but I believe in love.
Like comets believe in racing.
Or moons. And wave making.
Damn it, I need this love.
Like Orion needs his belt.
And Gemini needs their twin.
The universe needs entropy.
You see the good in me. I need you like astronauts need air.
And Uranus needs stones.
I mean, Saturn needs its ring.
And space needs all these floaty things.
Or NASA needed hidden figures. I figured out the equations of my heart and it's you. Baby, I'm in need of your love.
Like stars need dusting.
Like planets need rotating.
I need you more than this shit needs gravity.
I'm looking at the stars right now.
Dreaming of your heavenly body.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I'm praying to catch me listening. I'm praying to catch me listening.
doing, my love?
Out of it.
but no matter where I go, I can't seem to feel it. I've never sensed what you all do. Never known what you long for, what you hunger for, what you crave. I wish I could get it. I just don't get love. So why bother trying?
None of us get it! Maybe things were never meant to be about just us. Perhaps we were always supposed to be the purpose. Maybe our bodies and colliding coexistence was just a part of the divine equation. But this, what hate is spouting, it's not the right way. And yet somehow I'm starting to believe that we were never meant to be alone.
It's okay if you haven't figured out love. None of us really have. I wasn't sure what it was before we first started, and I'm still not quite sure, but I know it feels amazing despite the pain. Before, all I could do was dream about what love could be. I could only hope that someone loved me once. I may never know what love is because maybe it's not up to us to know like the gods do. But I know I have it in me.
You don't have to feel rejected or unsure or misunderstood anymore. I can't speak for everyone here. But I, for one, can't wait to get to know you better and take care of you. Whenever you're feeling down or unwell, I'll be there to make sure that your cup of tea has no less than 5 scoops of sugar. 5 scoops to help you understand how I feel. To know that I bent over the stove and watched the water boil as my back ached. I want to layer the bottom of a porcelain mug with pure, raw, wildflower honey. And a splash of robitussin. I want my love savored and swallowed whole, and I know that deep down you want the same.
Love is a beautiful thing when you have or feel it. Like if you think about the concept of the calm before the storm, think of it as the storm that never came. That's what it feels like. Just pure safety, as if nothing can harm or fuck with your vibe because you know you're loved. You must understand that you too can feel this love, even if that love isn't perfect. Who the fuck said love and perfection had to coincide?
Over my many lifetimes, I felt the entire range of love. I felt manic and obsessive. I felt lost in the great sea of my emotions. I've even caused pain to others because of it and felt the pain that they caused me. But trying to find a home in someone, that was never my mistake. I've been a safe space for others. I've been a rock for them. And that's not to say that I'm perfect or that loving is easy or perfect. Because I know what it's like to feel unsure, unworthy, and still have someone stand there right there beside you. If someone's worth it, no matter your differences, you go to the ends of time to let them know.
Without love's presence wrapped around us, who is it that we become exactly? We can't make you feel what you do not. But let us try, because I can't bear to watch you become a denizen of forgotten anymore. I think I'm finally understanding what it means to be a person. Love reminded me that to make myself more myself, I must mold myself with the tools I build from others. That includes you. I'm so sorry no one ever told you that love is a tool. I finally understand why your toolbox was never full. I want my tools back, don't you? I can only imagine what it's like to never have known at all. I think that this is what it feels like, but who really knows? But that's the beauty of it. I can't promise you what happens if you choose love, but one thing I can promise you is that this feels better than any feeling I've been able to remember until now, because this feeling isn't memory, it's transference and transcendence and reconnection. It's the closest to someone's God I've felt in a long time. And the minute she comes back to you, it's as if she never left at all.
Love's an idiot!
Jealous bitch.
You haven't won! I'm still here!
and so will we. Ladies and gentlemen, thank you so much for coming to the 10th anniversary of Art After Dark. We just want to say we love you all so much. Thank you for supporting us. Thank you for coming all the way out here from campus to this space. Thank you for continuing to support our organization, everything that we do. Thank you for showing up and loving us. Thank you to all the seniors. It has been an incredible time here, and we are working against the clock because we got to get out of this space because we are over time. But thank you all so much for being here. We will meet you in the lobby, and we love you all so, so much. Good night.